Lastly, let's talk about middle Riemann sums, also known as the midpoint rule. Here, our area of each rectangle will be found by multiplying our base, just like we did for the other two methods. And this will be multiplied by the outpoint of the middle of a rectangle, hence the name midpoint rule. Writing out our general middle Riemann sum formula, you can see that we are now using the midpoint. So xi plus xi minus 1 divided by 2. Now, let's write out the equation for middle Riemann sums if we have unequal step sizes, just like we did for the other ones. If all of our rectangles here are taken to be the same width, we can again factor out this delta x term and move it to the outside of our summation term. One thing to note here about these types of Riemann sums is that they can both overestimate and underestimate the actual integral value, depending on the concavity and behavior of the function within each subinterval. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I'll do my best to address your concerns.